Let's take this question now, and this question is about paragraph summary. A para is given to us here, and this paragraph is followed by four summaries that you see in the form of options, and we have to pick the one that correctly captures the essence of the text, in the sense that the main idea of the text is correctly captured by that particular option. So let's read the paragraph to see what exactly it is all about. It says, the conceptualization of landscape as a geometric object first occurred in Europe and is historically related to the European conceptualization of the organism, particularly the human body, as a geometric object with parts having a rational three-dimensional organization and integration. So this is a very, very long sentence, and we have to get to the crux of it. It says, the conceptualization of landscape as a geometric object first occurred in Europe and is related to the European conceptualization of the organism, particularly the human body, is a geometric object with parts having. So the conceptualization of landscape as a geometric object is somehow connected with the conceptualization of the human being as a geometric object. So if I have to pick some of the key points from this long sentence, it is basically the conceptualization of the landscape as a geometric object, which has been derived from the conceptualization of human beings as geometric object. The European idea of landscape appeared before the science of landscape emerged, and is no coincidence that Renaissance artists such as Leonardo da Vinci, who studied the structure of the human body, also facilitated an understanding of the structure of the landscape. So now so the conceptualization of landscape as geometric object is somehow connected with the geometric form of the human body. And this is also further, the author further says that the European idea of landscape appeared before the science of landscape emerged. And it is no coincidence that Renaissance artists such as Da Vinci, who studied the structure of the human body, also facilitated the understanding of the structure of a landscape. So the structure, the conceptualization of the landscape was also facilitated by the Renaissance artists such as Da Vinci. Landscape, which had been a subordinate background to religious or historical narratives, became an independent genre or subject of art by the end of the 16th century or the beginning of the 17th century. So the whole paragraph seems to be about landscape, how it originated, and then Renaissance artists also contributed to some extent, and then landscape, which had been a subordinate background to religious or historical narratives, became an independent genre. So the whole para seems to be about landscape. Now let's look at the options. Chapter 1 says, landscape became a major subject of art at the turn of the 16th century. So it says, at the turn of the 16th century, landscape became a major. It can be one of the options. Now let's look at the other ones. The three-dimensional understanding of the organism in Europe led to a similar approach towards the understanding of landscape. And then the study of landscape as an independent genre was aided by Renaissance artists. And the Renaissance artists were responsible for the study of landscape as a, so it was definitely aided, but they were not responsible. I mean, the option 4 goes out. Definitely, because it says the Renaissance artists were responsible for the study of landscape. They were not responsible, but they were actually assisting, or they assisted, or they helped in it. So it is given here that they facilitated, right? So the word facilitated goes well with the word aided here, right? So you can connect these two words, and therefore we can say that 4 is definitely not the right choice. And then now we have to look from the other three choices. The study of landscape as an independent genre was aided. It makes sense, and it could be one of the key ideas that is being discussed in the paragraph. And the three-dimensional understanding of the organism in Europe led to a similar approach towards understanding of landscape. So it says that the three-dimensional understanding led to a similar approach towards the understanding of landscape. Now this is a little problematic option. It says here that the three-dimensional organization and integration. So it says here the conceptualization of landscape is historically related to European conceptualization of the organism, particularly. So it is related to, understand this people, the conceptualization of landscape as a geometric object is related to what the conceptualization of the organism as a geometric object. But the option C says that it had a similar approach. Now the paragraph is not talking about the approach. The paragraph says the conceptualization of landscape as a geometric symbol is related to the conceptualization of the organism as a three-dimensional something. But it is related doesn't mean that they had a similar approach. So what you're doing in option two, you are basically misinterpreting the whole thing. The paragraph says that they are related, and you in the option come and say that they had a similar approach. That's why it is not the right choice. Two is definitely distorting the information given. So we have to pick from one or three. One says landscape became a major art at the turn of the 16th century. So it says landscape, which had been a subordinate background to religious or historical narrative, became an independent genre or subject of art. So it became an independent subject of art by the end of 16th century, and you say it became a major subject of art. So the whole idea is, was it a major subject of art or was it an independent genre? Because something which is an independent need not be a major. So in all the options, we are looking for those words which are likely to distort the options. So a major subject is one thing, an independent genre or subject is another thing. Something which is an independent genre need not be a major subject. Independent basically means free from other things and pursued on its own or for its own thing. So we don't have the independent matching with the word major, and therefore one goes out. Three is the best answer. Why? Because there is no flaw with option three. The study of landscape was an independent, option three. The study of landscape as an independent genre was aided by Renaissance artists. Now you might wonder whether this is the essence of the text. See, the point here is that out of all the four options, even though three is not the essence of the entire paragraph, it is somewhat matching with what is given in the paragraph. That the author seems to be saying that the study of landscape as the art form was definitely assisted by the Renaissance artists. And statement three is very much parallel to that. All the other options go out because they are distorting the idea that is given in the paragraph. One says it was a major subject of art, and two says that they had a similar approach, and four speaks about responsibility. So the word "were responsible," the word "major subject," and the word "similar approach," these actually are not matching with what is given in the paragraph. And therefore, out in the given context, three is the best choice and the right answer.